God bless you. Thank you for being with us today. We are Abundant Grace Church. I'm Bishop Ramon DeMaria, and I'm the senior pastor of the church. For truly, this is the day that the Lord has made, and we shall all rejoice and be glad in it. We just praise God for the opportunity to stand before you today. We're going to welcome all of our viewers and all of our listeners to our service today. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, in Jesus' name, thank you for this blessed day. Thank you for replenishing the earth with the rain. We thank you for giving us another day in which to live, giving us another day in which to minister and to be ministered to. Let your word go forth in power, strength, and anointing. And we thank you, Father God, for all those that are tuned in today, for those that will come to the cross of Jesus Christ and say, what must I do to be saved? And we praise you, Father God, for all your blessings. In Jesus' name we pray and thank you. Amen. We're going to continue with part two of our message series titled, Continue to Serve Jesus Christ. And in parentheses, your service is not pointless. Our main scripture is from 1 Corinthians chapter 15 and verse 58, which reads from the King James Version, therefore, my beloved brethren, be steadfast, unmovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord. For as much as you know that your labor is not in vain in the Lord. My beloved, we are facing difficult times where people are coming against the church of our Savior and Lord Jesus Christ. But know that their attempts are in vain. Because Jesus told us that he will never leave us, nor will he forsake us, that he is with us always until the end of the age. So with Jesus on our side, Jesus is the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. What do we have to worry about? Nothing. We are to cast our care upon him because he cares for us. Four, his yoke is easy and his burden is light. Amen. Today we will open up with 1 Corinthians chapter 15 and verse 55. O death, where is thy sting? O grave, where is thy victory? My beloved, this verse here is very important because it is a triumphant sound of the Apostle Paul. As he says, I want to be free from the power of the grave. I want to reclaim them from death. My beloved, Paul had a desire to be set free from the pains of death. We too should have that desire. But we will all face death, physical death. But we will never face spiritual death. Because as Christians, as true Christians, we have received Jesus Christ as our Savior and Lord. And therefore, we have eternal life with him forever. What a blessing. Give the Lord a praise. Because we do not have to worry about going to torment or going to hell. Because through Jesus Christ, we have overcome death, hell, and the grave. Because he overcame and is now sitting at the right hand of God the Father in the place of power and majesty. Now there's no denying that if the rapture doesn't take place, we will die and go by way of the grave. Now many choose to be cremated. That's their choice. But those of us that choose to be buried We will be raised again. And we will be taken into the presence of God through our Savior and Lord Jesus Christ. So we have the victory through Jesus Christ. The grave will not hold us down. And those that are cremated or drowned or are put into the sea, like if they die on a ship or whatever, guess what? God is able to bring their bodies together totally and raise them up on that day. There is nothing that God cannot do or will not do for those that come to Him in repentance and receive His free gift of eternal life through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. What shall separate us from the love of God which is in Christ Jesus? Nothing. 1 Corinthians chapter 15 and verse 56 says, the sting of death is sin, and the strength of sin is the law. Which means by the law, by the Old Testament law, you have got to do certain things. You have got to make sacrifice. You've got to obey every part of the law, which is impossible. But through Jesus Christ, you receive the grace of God. And that lasts for eternity. Once you come to Christ, you are in Christ, and no one can take that from you. Sin gives death. Its sting. And God's standards give sin its power. It is sin that brought mankind under the power of death. And that happened in the Garden of Eden. It was Adam's sin that brought him his death and ours. The power of sin is the law. The law of God gives sin its power. For it reveals our sin and condemns us because of our sin. When we are aware of what is sin, when we come to the age of accountability, we are responsible for our sinfulness. Mm-hmm. When you are presented with the gospel of Jesus Christ through a tract, through an evangelist, through a missionary, through another Christian, and you refuse, you become liable for each and every sin that you have committed, will commit in the future. My beloved, the only way to escape the judgment of God for sin is to receive Jesus Christ as your Savior and Lord. And that can only happen through repentance and being sorry for your sins and believing that Jesus Christ is the Savior of all mankind. My beloved, without the law, sin could have no power, but the sting none can resist because we are living in this flesh. We cannot resist sin in the flesh. The only way we can resist sin is through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. We are going to sin every day, but as Christians, we can go to God the Father through Jesus Christ. And He is our lawyer, let's call Him. He is the one that intercedes for us to the Father. And our sins are covered in His precious blood. Now and forever. That is why we will not have to go to a devil's hell for eternity. But those that refuse will be there for eternity. So, sin gets its strength from the law. 1 Corinthians chapter 15 and verse 57 reads, but thanks be to God, which giveth us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. My beloved, there is no way to heaven except through Jesus Christ. Mm-hmm. You cannot conquer the grave except through Jesus Christ. You cannot conquer death except through Jesus Christ. You cannot you cannot conquer sin because you are not able to. Because you live in sinfulness. You breathe in sinfulness. Your body is sin. So, you cannot come to the cross of Jesus Christ without a desire to repent of your sin. Many people go down to the altar, but their heart isn't in repentance. Their heart isn't in giving up their sinfulness. They don't want to give it up because they love it. They love sin. The body loves sin. We are sinful. And it is only because of the blood of Jesus Christ that we are able to be upright, to be righteous before the Heavenly Father. Without Jesus, there is only death, torment, and a lake of fire for eternity. But with Christ is victory over sin, victory over death. There is victory totally through Jesus Christ. Jesus won the victory over sin and has put it away by the sacrifice of himself. He has finished and made an end to it, for it reigns over his people before conversion and dwells in them after it. Yet, in consequence of his atonement for it, it loses its governing power. It has no authority over you. Now, you can give in to sin, but it has no power over you unless you let it have power. But through Jesus Christ, you have the victory if you want to have victory. You are a winner. But there's certain things that you must do, and that is believe on the Lord Jesus Christ. Continue to serve him. Repent of your sins every day. Serve him. Listen to his voice. Listen to his guidance through the Holy Spirit. And you will walk in total victory. Only through the Holy Spirit and the grace of God in Jesus Christ can you be regenerated entirely and not fall to the damning power of sin over you. Do you want to be free today? Come to the altar when I give the altar call and receive Jesus Christ as your Savior and Lord. 1 Corinthians chapter 15 and verse 58 says, therefore, my beloved brethren, be steadfast, immovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord, for as much as you know that your labor is not in vain in the Lord. God will not forget your good works for him. God will never cast you away because Jesus Christ paid the price, not you. He will never deny his son. The Father will never deny his son and his work on Calvary. Never. He cannot go against his word. My beloved, know that. If God be for you, who can be against you? It is God that gave his only begotten son. That cannot ever change. The Word of God is eternal. It is without end. And the Word of God is the same yesterday, today, and forever. And the Word of God became flesh. And his name is Jesus Christ. So be ye steadfast and unmovable in all the doctrines of the gospel, and particularly in the resurrection of the dead. My beloved, believe that no matter what happens to you in this earth, you will be raised incorruptible on the day when God calls every true Christian to heaven. We believe in the rapture. Of course, there will be those that will not go up in the rapture because they have not yet repented. But there is a second coming, and it will be a resurrection, and they will be with God through Jesus Christ forever. But we have the blessed hope that we will be taken in the rapture. If I don't get to see the rapture, I know that immediately when I die, my soul will be in heaven. And I know that at the resurrection, on the last day, my body will go to meet my soul and to be in heaven forever. And that is the blessed hope that we have as true Christians. But you know, not everybody believes that. Not everybody believes in God. Not everybody believes in Jesus Christ. That's why we as Christians need to pray for the lost. Continue to preach the gospel. Continue to evangelize. Continue to minister. Continue to give drink to the thirsty, clothes to the naked, food to the hungry, that they may see your good works and glorify God. And come to the altar and say, "What must I do to be saved?" My beloved, we cannot shy back from doing the work that God has called us to do, no matter what we are facing. We are facing adversity. We are facing difficult times. But the church must stand and be triumphant, because we have the power through Jesus Christ. We are going through trials in this nation, but we are still one nation under God, and that will never change. You can't do away with God. You can't overcome God. Never. It's impossible. God is supreme. God is all-powerful. He is all-knowing. He is everywhere at every minute. He knows everyone's mind. He knows the future. And we as Christians know what he has revealed to us through his word. And that in the end it says, we have the victory. Those that are coming against the church right now in our country, they will fall in defeat. And unless they repent, they will end up in the eternal lake of fire. It's dangerous. It's dangerous out there, yes. But we had the victory, because although our bodies be destroyed, our soul lives forever. And it will live with our Savior and Lord Jesus Christ forever. Don't fear what man can do to you. Fear what God can do to you, because he has the power to cast you into hell. Those that are coming against Jesus Christ, those that want to remove his name, those that want to kill innocent babies, they have a price to pay. And they will pay. Unless they repent, they will burn in hell forever. From the president down to the lowest person on the totem pole, they will pay the price. It is written. What if God says, "I am the Lord thy God. Thou shalt not have any false gods before me." These people have Satan as their god, a false god. They are led astray by lies. They have fallen victim to evil, but they shall pay. When we are rejoicing in heaven for eternity, they will be burning and crying in the lake of fire forever. Where do you want to spend eternity? I ask you that today. Do you spend eternity in heaven or in the lake of fire? Do you want to have victory or defeat? My beloved, in closing, let me say this. Because of the resurrection of Jesus Christ and our resurrection, we know that serving Him is not empty labor or useless activity, and our labor is not in vain. Our effort is invested in Christ's winning cause. Know that He is going to reward us at the rapture and at His second coming. Should we go by the way of death and the grave? Remember that nothing we do for God is ever a waste of time. At times we hesitate to do good because we do not see the results. But if we maintain a heavenly perspective, we understand that our labor is not in vain. We may not see the results now. How many grandmothers prayed for the grandchildren and never saw them come to the cross? But at their funeral or down the road, they came to the cross of Jesus Christ. You need to pray for our nation, no matter how bad it looks. Pray for your lost family members, no matter how bad they seem to be. Because your prayers will not go unanswered. Don't allow discouragement over an apparent lack of results keep you from working endlessly for Jesus Christ. Do the good that you have the opportunity to do, knowing that your work for Christ will have eternal results in your life and in the lives of many others. Amen. My beloved, words of encouragement as the title of our message, continue to serve Jesus Christ. Your service is not pointless. Keep the faith. Don't give up. Never give up. For your labor is not in vain in the Lord. And in saying that, let me offer you the opportunity to receive Jesus Christ as your Savior and Lord. The criterion is that you must repent of your sins. Be sorry for your sins. Believe that Jesus Christ is the Savior, that He was crucified, died, buried, rose from the dead on the third day, and ascended into heaven. And is sitting at the right hand of God the Father in the place of power and majesty, from where He shall come to judge the dead and the living. That is the Apostles' Creed, the Nicene Creed. Look it up on the internet. And look it over and let it speak to you. But right now, I want to offer you the opportunity to become a Christian. I know some of you might say, well, I know so-and-so, he says he's a Christian, or he goes to this church, or this or that. That's not the focus here today. Remember, everyone has a sinful nature. Everyone isn't perfect. I'm not perfect. None of our members here are perfect. But we strive for perfection. See, and you can't understand that unless you come to the cross of Jesus Christ and become saved. Then you will have a better understanding of what it means to become a Christian. So, if you'd like to join the true Christian church, become a Christian by receiving Jesus Christ as your Savior and Lord through repentance of your sins, I want to lead you in a model prayer. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, in Jesus' name, I heard the message today. It has touched my heart. I am not a Christian, but but I want to be today. I am sorry for my sins. I believe that Jesus Christ of Nazareth is the Savior of all mankind, that he was crucified, died, buried, rose from the dead on the third day, ascended into heaven, and is now sitting at your right hand in the place of power and majesty, from where he shall come to judge the dead and the living. I believe that today. And I'm sorry for my sins. I ask you to forgive me of my sins. Wash me and cleanse me. To save me. And to take me to heaven with you when I die or the rapture takes place. And I believe today by faith that I have become a Christian because I have repented and put my total faith and trust in Jesus Christ as my Savior and Lord. In Jesus' name I pray, amen. My beloved, if you truly repented, let me be the first one to welcome you into the kingdom of God. Now, what I want you to do is go to a Bible preaching, teaching church. One that preaches the Word of God in its wholeness, from the book of Genesis to the book of Revelation. Get an audience with a pastor. Tell him what happened. Ask him to pray with you, to pray for you, to anoint you with oil, and to baptize you by full immersion in water in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Then what I would like you to do is ask him to mentor you and give you a Bible if you haven't one. Then please email me at abundant.grace@att.net and just highlight it or earmark it, pastor, and I will get it. You can contact me through our website at www.abundantgracechurch.net or our other website at www.abundantgraceofmidlothian.com. You can Google us. Just put in my name, Bishop Ramon DeMaria, or Abundant Grace Church of Midlothian, Texas. We're on Facebook, Twitter, Spreaker. You can contact us. But please, let me hear from you. Remember, email me at abundant.grace@att.net. God bless you, my beloved. This closes our message series. This is part two, titled Continue to Serve Jesus Christ. Your service is not pointless. God bless you, my beloved. Have a wonderful day. Have a wonderful life. And remember, God loves you and sent Jesus to die for you. We are Abundant Grace Church. I'm Bishop Ramon DeMaria, and I'm the senior pastor of the church. Go with God, my beloved.